Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back with a new lecture with LCMS-MS. If you want to analyze specific parameters in a specific matrix, you should develop a method for analysis of these parameters in this matrix. And then you should optimize your instrument, your mass, to be able to detect and quantify your parameters. And this is the acquisition method. But first, you should listen to the previous lectures to understand this lecture. You should know that there are some parameters in the ion source and mass analyzer should be optimized to control the behavior of ions along the ion path from the ion source to mass analyzer then to detector, and also to get the precursor ion and product ions for your target analytes. Also, you should know that these parameters will be different for different analytes, because for each analyte there are specific product ions. So there will be also specific parameters for each analyte to get its product ion. So these parameters also will be different for different analytes. Before you will build your acquisition method, you should understand what each parameter controls and how it affects mass spectral resolution, intensity, and peak shape, so you can build your acquisition method which will be fit for your target analytes, and also you can achieve optimal results during sample analysis. As you know that ion source used for ionization of analyte molecules to produce ions, and then these ions will be transferred to the mass analyzer. For this process of ionization, we need nebulizer gas, temperature, and also ion spray voltage. Ion spray voltage, which is one parameter of your acquisition method, and this is voltage applied to the needle or electrode that will help nebulizer gas and temperature to ionize the sample molecules and produce ions. But that will be in the electrospray ionization ion source, not found in atmospheric pressure chemical ionization ion source. But in atmospheric pressure chemical ionization, there is nebulizer current instead of ion spray voltage that will be applied to the corona discharge. This voltage depend on flow rate and polarity of compounds. If you increase the flow rate for your solvent carrying sample molecules coming from HPLC to the ion source, in this case you need to increase the ion spray voltage to the optimum range to be able to help the nebulizer gas and temperature to ionize your sample molecules, and also affect spray stability and sensitivity. Also, as you know that L1 carrying sample molecules will be transferred from HPLC to the ion source, and in the ion source these L1 carrying sample molecules will be nebulized by nebulizer gas and temperature to spray droplets, which consists of sample molecules surrounded by solvent molecules. But you should know that only analyte ions should be transferred from the ion source to the mass analyzer. So these solvent molecules should be removed by the aid of desolvation gas and temperature. These solvent molecules can be removed, but also there is a potential applied, which is the clustering potential. The clustering potential, which is voltage applied to the orifice, which is opening before the mass analyzer, where ions enter the mass analyzer for the clustering, used for the clustering of solvent cluster ions, to minimize the number of solvent cluster ions entering the mass, or to remove the solvent cluster ions entering to the mass analyzer, and also helps to transfer only analyte ions from ion source to the mass analyzer. The clustering potential, or dB, is a very important parameter in your acquisition method. Should be optimized for each target analyte, because there will be specific dB for each analyte. The higher the voltage applied, the greater the amount of declustering. If you increase dB, also the amount of declustering for solvent cluster ions will increase. But if you increase dB more than enough, what will happen? Your analyte ions also may be fragmented. So you should get the optimum dB for your target analytes. So there will be specific dB for each analyte, and that will be ranged from 0 up to 300 voltage in positive mode, and from minus 300 to 0 voltage in negative mode. So you will optimize your instrument for each analyte to get the optimum dB for each of them. After that, we have Curtin gas, which is a very important gas. Curtin gas is a counterflow of a high purity nitrogen gas that will prevent neutral molecules, solvent droplets, and solid particles from entering the mass analyzer. But only analyte ions will be accelerated against the gas to the mass analyzer by attractive potential gradient. What does it mean, attractive potential gradient? As we know that potentials will be applied to all parts of the mass, from ion source to the detector, and will be decreased gradually to help ions to transfer from the ion source to the detector. This Curtin gas, in the name of Curtin gas, in AB Sykes instrument, but you will find is in adjuvant, as example, you will find drying gas. So it will be different, the name will be different from an instrument to another instrument, but the function is the same. As we can see in this process, first nebulizer gas will be applied in the ion source for nebulizing of anyone carrying sample molecules to form spray droplets or aerosol. These droplets consists of sample molecules surrounded by solvent molecules in positive mode and in negative mode. But we need only analyte ions to be transferred from ion source to the mass analyzer, so solvent molecules should be evaporated. And that will be by the effect of desolvation gas or turbo gas and temperature. And after that, also ion spray voltages that, as we said in the beginning of this lecture, will be applied in the ion source also for ionization, to help in ionization of analyte molecules to produce ions, analyte ions. Then these ions will be transferred through the Kelvin plate to the interface between Kelvin plate and the orifice, and Kelvin gas will be applied in this place to prevent neutral molecules, solvent droplets, or solid particles from entering the mass analyzer. And on the orifice also there is potential, other potential applied, which is the clustering potential, as we said. That potential applied to the orifice for the clustering of solvent cluster ions, to minimize the number of solvent cluster ions entering the mass analyzer, or to remove it. So only analyte ions will be transferred to the mass analyzer. After that, we will have other parameters for the mass analyzer. And we have here all types of gases applied to the ion source. Nebulizer gas, gas 1, for nebulization of anyone carrying sample molecules to spray droplets. If solvent flow rate is high, gas 1 also should be high. So we should optimize this, and that depends on the solvent flow rate. If flow rate from 1 to 20 microliter per minute, you have gas 1 should be 20. From 100 to 2000 microliter per minute, you have gas 1 from 40 up to 80, and you will optimize this. Turbo gas or desolvation gas, gas 2, for evaporation of solvent, also by the aid of temperature. Curtin gas, as we discussed before, to prevent curtin gas or drying gas, to prevent any solvent droplets, neutral molecules, solid particles from entering the mass analyzer. And in Sykes instrument, you will find entrance potential. Entrance potential applied to Q0 region. As we said, in Sykes, they have Q-jet, in Trevicol, they have Q-jet ion guide. After that, transfer ions to Q0 region, then to Q1, then to Q2, then product ions to Q3. Not like other instruments, they have only Q1, Q2, Q3. So this entrance potential applied to Q0 region to focus ions through Q0 to Q1, and from Q0 to Q1. And as we know that Q1 also is a mass filter to select the precursor ions that will be transferred to the Q2, which is collision cell. And there is a potential applied also to Q1, which is road offset, and that also will be optimized. Then in Q2, we have Q2, which is collision cell. We have collision, CAD or collisionally activated dissociation gas. This is gas, nitrogen gas also applied to the ions, the precursor ions in the Q2 for fragmentation. It will help for fragmentation of precursor ion to form product ions, which are specific for each precursor ion. So collision in collision cell, we have fragmentation to form our product ions for our target analytes. And also there is a collision energy applied in collision cell. This collision energy, amount of energy applied to precursor ion, this amount of energy applied to precursor ion also to help in fragmentation of precursor ion to form product ions. And we have also CXP or collision exit, collision cell exit potential, and this is potential applied also in Q2 to focus and accelerate product ions after fragmentation. We get product ions that will accelerate, will help to accelerate product ions out of collision cell to be transferred to Q3, which is also mass filter for product ions to be transferred to the detector. That was the end of our lecture for today. Inshallah, in the next lecture, I will explain also other parameters related to the acquisition method, such as dwell time, cycle time, duty cycle. See you in the next lecture, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.